Hello everyone, welcome to yet another edition of Tarmak Talking. This is Anantha Krishnan here, and today I am at the flight hangar of LCA Tejas Division of Hindustan Aeronautics Limited in Bangalore. And there's a very special reason why we are here today, because the first flight of Tejas SP-21, the first from the FOC series, is going to take to the skies for the first time. It is going to be piloted by Air Commodore K. Muthanna, the Chief of Test Flying of the Fixed Wing Department of HAL, a very seasoned Indian Air Force test pilot. So we will be getting you the first visuals, the video from the first flight. Also, very interesting thing lined up once he lands after his maiden flight. Post that, we are lining up the superheroes of LCA Tejas Division of HAL, the men and women working behind this great mission, the great fighter Tejas. So there are around 20 people lined up for a very informal chat. 20 people who have been part of this project, who have traveled with Tejas for various missions of Indian Air Force, people who have traveled to Bahrain, people who have gone for the Lima air show, and people who have been part of Tejas for a long time. So we will get to hear from them as well. So sit back and enjoy as we get you a very special edition of Tarmak Talking to mark the very historic first flight of Tejas SP-21.
This is a very momentous occasion for us. SP-21 is the first FOC aircraft which is going to roll out from the stables of LCA Division. In fact, all the technicians behind and the supervisors behind, along with the stakeholders like RCMA and DGIQ very specifically, have put in tremendous effort to make this event possible on time.
This is a proud moment for all of us in HAL and everybody who's associated with the LCA project. Today with the first flight of SP-21, this is a major milestone which we are achieving in our supplies for the block of FOC aircrafts to the Air Force. This was possible when we got the SOP in February 2019. In 12 months' time, we have pulled out the first aircraft for Air Force, and this was possible with the support of the Chief of Air Staff, Semelak, our HAL team, so that we could manage the first aircraft in 12 months.
From the user's point of view, what are the expectations to this particular program?
First of all, I have to express a sincere thanks to Indian Air Force, Chief of Air Staff and his team. They worked together with us for the success of this today's program also. We are also working with us to make the more and more aircraft to be rolled out for the formation of the second squadron at Sulu. That's why they're looking for it. Really, the wonderful support they have given to us. And we are same thing, I expected that they are going to support for future also.
What has been your most unforgettable moment being part of this LCA division so far?
My experience goes with the various projects like Toyota project, transport technology projects, and export projects. There is entirely a different project compared to LCA project. It's a concurrent engineering, indigenous design development. When the aircraft is building, is taking place, a lot of changes are also happening in the design board that we are incorporating parallelly and making success. There's a great learning in this program.
Very, very proud of you, Mr. Yogi. I hope more Tejas fighters fly out under your leadership in the coming days. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Anand.
What all things did you do during the first flight?
First of all, after the drawings are given to manufacturing unit, normally it takes 2 to 3 years at least for the product to come out. Okay, FOC here was declared in February 2019. Okay, and the aircraft was out within 1 year and 2 months or so. But also in this process, what happens is that lot of different aspects which are not there in the IOC have to be absorbed over here. One is doing this integration in the limited series production aircraft and being test flown by NFTC. And but unfortunately what happens is that since, as I said before, this is the first piece where everything is coming together.
All right.
Not individually.
Okay.
And therefore there will be some kind of difficulties in terms of finding adequate space, finding adequate space between looms, between pipelines and things like that. So those are the things that I think Tejas division has worked very hard at, and finally has managed to convince all the agencies, especially the Directorate General of Aircraft Quality Assurance. They were very, very strict on this program, and they had to be satisfied. Even as of yesterday, they had a lot of queries, almost many queries had to be answered, and the team has been working almost 24 hours through 3 shifts to get this aircraft out.
So what did you do during today's first sortie?
Today is the first sortie that, externally what you see is that the first time a production aircraft is going up with this air-to-air refueling probe. It also for the first time has the gun, I was carrying the gun, and also I was carrying the midboard pylons for the first time.
All right.
Okay, so the first profile basically aims to check the engine performance. That means I have to take it to what we call as the upper left-hand corner. That is at the very high and very low speeds, and I have to slam the engine from idle bar into afterburner and see that she picks up smoothly and goes into afterburner.
All right.
Thereafter, I go supersonic and check that she meets the supersonic acceleration in a certain period of time.
All right.
Okay. Thereafter, I check the limits of many aspects, like for example, air brake limits and. Okay. The limits of what we call as the speed lock.
Okay.
Thereafter, I come down and now in this sortie, we take her up to an angle of attack of about 18 degrees a clean aircraft. Thereafter, now they will calibrate, see that it is checking okay. There is no mistrack between the different vanes, and now they will clear us to go to the maximum angle of attack of 24 degrees in the next sortie. So I did that initial calibration both with undercarriage down and with undercarriage up, and thereafter I took her up to 8G for the first time. So the previous IOC aircraft was up to 6G.
All right.
And it was incredible to see her now, smoothly go up to 8G. Great feeling it was that yes, we are there for the time being.
Did you do the mandatory inverted flying this time?
Yes, I did the mandatory inverted flying, and she performed beautifully. And thereafter, to check the harmonization of controls and things like that, we have to do some aerobatics. So I enjoyed myself in the beautiful blue skies.
So just for the curiosity of a lot of youngsters watching this program, what do you intend to do when you do an inverted flight? And how do you, what's that experience of seeing world upside down?
Upside down? No. Before you do an inverted, first thing you check that there are no loose articles in the cockpit, that you haven't left a pencil here and the FOD.
Yeah.
Thereafter you tighten yourself up, and then you invert her, and then you have to give a lot of push force on the control circuit. You are maintaining that negative 1G flight, and this I have to maintain for a certain duration which is specified in the test profile, so that you see that there are no fuel warnings coming, etc. And thereafter you come back, and yes, it's a great thing to see the earth upside down. But inverted flight continuous is not a very, very enjoyable state of flight, so it's not that you're enjoying inverted flight, but it's a thing to be done.
Your career in Air Force and in HALS has been truly, truly inspiring. Having flown many platforms and logging, thousands of hours, what is that makes Tejas special?
To me, what makes Tejas special is that it is our own design in terms of the airframe. It is our own flight control design, which is an incredibly satisfying aspect that I say every time. It's a beautiful aircraft to fly. The entire avionics suite is our own, which means that we can seamlessly integrate new weapons, new systems. We don't have to mimic other systems or other weapons, foreign weapons. And there's a lot of interaction between the avionics and the flight control system that can also be seamlessly meshed. These two are the basic biggest advantages of this.
All right. So very proud of you, sir.
And
thank you. Congratulations once again for this great success of SP21.
Yeah. Thanks. Thank you, Anand. Yeah. Thank you very much.
All right, so all of us witnessed a fantastic, inspiring first flight of Tejas SP21, the first FOC variant to fly out of Hindustan Aeronautics Limited here in Bangalore. Now, it's time for us to shift to next segment of this Tarmak Talking, where we are moving to the Tejas final assembly hangar, where a bunch of superheroes are waiting to have a very informal chat with us. Let us go there to listen to their inspiring stories, stories of their struggle, their passion and success, and what makes them so passionately attached to this fantastic flying mission, the Desi Bird, Tejas. I am standing right now at the final assembly hangar of LCA Tejas Division, and behind me you can see the piping hot brand new SP21, the first FOC variant, which just completed the first flight successfully at the HAL airport here. So today, let's have a very informal chat with all these superheroes of Tejas program, who has given their entire life, their day in and day out, Saturdays, Sundays, everything for this project in the last 2-3 years. Leading them from the front is Mr. Yogi. He's a ED LCA, the boss of this division, very, very inspiring, unassuming man, and a team of youngsters whom he has built over the years. So let's straight away first go to Mr. Yogi. And first of all, sir, congratulations, and you know, a very, very, very happy moment to all Indians across the globe that Tejas SP21 has finally completed the first flight. I'm sure it's a very, very happy moment to all of you. What are your initial thoughts, sir?
Thank you, Mr. Anantha Krishnan. I think it is the happiest day in HAL, I can say. The team worked very well as the last 1 year, subsequent to the release of FOC Dal in February 19. We were able to produce the first aircraft within 1 year. And today I've seen the light of the day, aircraft SP21 has flown. The LCA team is a good support for me to achieve this target.
What are the key aspects that you could think of that went into the success of today's magnificent flight?
Yeah, the success of today's first flight of SP21, mainly due to the restructuring, I can say flat structure. I have given a delegation to each individuals, make them to understand what they're supposed to do, and responsibility has been fixed, and them, the voluntary, they contributed to the various tasks assigned to them to the culmination of this first flight today.
How much of effort you had to bring in, considering that there's already a hierarchy in place when you took over, to make it flat?
Initially, when the project started for FOC program, people were afraid. There was a team effort was required. Each member of my LCA team, all the corners of all the departments, I told them, this is a target to be set. And as a team, you have to work. And we also told them, this is a responsibility and you have to achieve this. And they've given a full freedom, delegations, everything, because that only the achievement has taken place.
I am Ravi, AGM project. You should ask us how this has helped us to meet the top management.
I really like that. So Ravi, you have the question now. Please give the answer.
So he has given us the freedom his thing is, he will tell you, this is what I want. So it is up to you to get the resources. If you want the resources, that also he will give you. But it is up to us. He gives you full freedom to take a decision and see that particular task is achieved.
All right. So I will come back to you guys again. So let me just come here to ask this young chap. How old are you?
36.
Okay, 36. And what's your name and where are you from?
So my name is Kalyan, sir. I'm from Kurnool, Andhra Pradesh.
How motivated are you working towards this project? And what is your specialization here?
Sir, I'm working for past 14 years in this project. I'm working structure assembly. So I've been motivated, like this is the only one division where people have got their own freedom to work, in respect of timings, whatever it is. So I've been motivated to work even for the extra hours. So because I've been given the freedom to work and finish the task within my limits.
So let me just go to the lady sitting next to you. So please introduce yourself and which is your section?
Yeah. Myself, Shivi Agarwal. Right now I'm looking planning department, but my specialization in looms. And I'm adding to the motivation part being in LCA. I have worked almost 14.5 years in LCA. I joined in LCA and still continuing with LCA. I have seen LCA growing with me.
Oh, okay.
It's like outside how people talk about LCA is a different story. The way we work for LCA is a different story. I don't remember a single day where our efficiency was ever down. It is more than required every time. Each person sitting here or who is not sitting here has put up efforts to make LCA what it is today. And it is a pride being in LCA. No other project will give us that pride that will give us LCA. And all our bosses, the most important thing, sir, we are so free to take decisions here. They have so much confidence in us, sir. That confidence gives us confidence to do things better for the company.
All right. So that's very interesting. So what is your name and what's your...
So I'm Sanjay Bansal. I am from Jaipur, Rajasthan.
Oh, Jaipur. Okay.
I'm here wing assembly engineering in HAL from last 12 years. Initially, my career was starting in the LCA Tejas division only.
What kind of stories have you gone back and told to the people of Jaipur? When you go back to Jaipur, do they look at you as, oh, somebody who is working with Tejas? Do the people of Jaipur know about Tejas?
Yeah, my friends, my colleagues, my relatives, as Tejas is the future of India, of HAL, everybody talks about me, how Tejas is working, what is the performance, where it has gone for testings, various parameters, all what achievement we all discussed, all has been discussed with my friends and relatives.
So we have somebody very inspiring here. So let me just ask the gentleman next to you. So what do you do?
I work in the power plant system.
And what's your name, sir?
My name is Rupesh.
Okay.
I'm from Bangalore. And since my schooling days, I was interested about Tejas.
Okay.
And luckily, I've been working here.
So you have been following this from school days?
Yes.
So what is your key contribution to this project?
I'm working in the power plant and fuel system, wherein we are part in the, we are supposed to be installing the engine and related instruments.
Let me ask you something very, very different. Who is the most naughty of this lot? There'll be somebody who is all, yeah? Ah, I was just looking, see everybody, like he's the most naughty, agree?
Yes, sir.
You know, why is he naughty? What makes him naughty? You know, can you just tell, sir, why is he naughty? Because?
Yeah, I'm being this boss, I always see that, always he make the fun, call the people, and make the environment enjoyable.
Okay.
So, and even you will pull the legs of so many people.
So, Manohar, you have been given as the most naughtiest, the whole world will see now, the most naughtiest team member of Tejas. But when you were in Bahrain, I've seen in different places. So, what is that job you do apart from your mandated thing?
When you go to the lay, wherever we have an minus 28 and 38 degrees, there we have an, some trials, low, very low altitude trials. That time, night time pilots will call and conduct a meeting that night, 9 o'clock, and they will tell that now we have to go base and we have to do the one engine run. This is an opportunity. We will go, we will do it, see, show that Tejas can do anything. So I'll make them inspire, and then if you go see outside how the snow will fall.
You are saying that at night 10 o'clock,
yes,
minus 28 degrees,
yes,
you will wake up your colleague,
yes,
and say, let's go and high and watch the snowfall.
Yes.
Amazing. And the pilots are waiting for the night
testing for the doing engine content.
Like, how will your colleagues respond when you go and knock and say, come out, we need to go out?
We will take a vehicle and we'll go and we'll listen the vehicle sound itself. My people all will be, oh, agaya. So like that, we are achieved many things. When we go for outstations, like Bahrain and all, the people, they're coming and asking by seeing HAL and Tejas. When I'm telling my inspiration, I'm expressing my thing. And people and families, they're coming and taking photograph with us. The way how we are giving support, 24 hours. My colleague, Mr. Prakash, he will experience, he will tell the greatest event of Palodi, how he has given 24 hours throughout the night.
We are seeing him as a naughty. He is not naughty. He is a great management guru. He will make the environment very light, but he will ensure that the work is completed. So he will not act like a boss that, yes, you have to complete this task. No. He will say, come, we'll enjoy there, we'll have some fun. And in fun, he will take out the work, we'll also enjoy, aircraft will fly and we'll feel very much happy. And so I will say he is not naughty, he is a great management guru.
So a great management guru who can perform fantastically even at minus 30 degrees.
Yes,
yes, sir. Bahrain was one air show, one international air show, probably the first one. Team Tejas, Team India, Team HAL really branded this amazing aircraft, right?
Yes, yes.
How was it for you being there, closer to the people, their emotions, their happiness? As he said, people coming and taking photographs, rubbing shoulders with other fighters in a real scenario. So, how was it?
My name is Nagbhushan. I am from Bidar, Karnataka. So, I am electrical equipping technician. When sir told, all outstation we have went for all the trials, hot weather, cold weather. When we went to Bahrain Air Show, there we found, oh, this is our aircraft. Actually, we were not knowing its capability. And it was, there was very less snag, and it was on time. And every flight we have concluded, and we have seen a very good performance comparing to all other air shows.
So, let me just take away totally to another aspect what she said to another youngster, Preekshit. You know, a lot of time we media always criticize HAL. She was telling that people say many things. But how do you guys stay focused despite all that people telling for various reasons?
Yeah, thanks, Anant. It's difficult at times, you know, to stay focused and stay motivated. I keep telling my team, the most difficult part of this program is to stay motivated, because we are under constant scrutiny and constant evaluation by our peers from across the country as well as from outside the country. But at the same time, the motivation level and the leadership being provided by our senior management always keeps us focused. And the external environment as such, most of the times whenever there's a negative news article or a particular incident which tries to put us back, the team is charged up, they are matured enough to understand these brickbats are for a larger reason. You know, the aircraft, we know the performance of the aircraft. We have seen it perform in Bahrain, we have seen it perform in Malaysia, and it has outperformed many of its contemporaries. So being confident of the product, being aware of the surroundings, we stay focused.
I remember, if you can hand it over to Yogi once again, because you have told your team to cut off from this noise and focus towards your goal, right? Now that you know this young, inspiring team of Tejas, are you confident that they will stay focused away from this noise?
There's no doubt about it. I definitely assure that this young team in LCA definitely focused and see that more and more aircrafts we produce in future. There's no doubt about it. Very well equipped in the all the fronts.
That is a captain always leading from the front, the Virat Kohli of HAL. LCA division is the future of HAL, everybody knows. Let me just now, you know, try to get, so all right, yeah. Scary story, all right. See, I like people propping up like this. Yeah, scary story.
Thank you, Anand. I'm Chakravarti, working in final assembly. I'm from Visakhapatnam, Andhra Pradesh. I'm here with Tejas division from past 15 years. The story is about an incident which happened during my deputation in Falodi in Gagan Shakti airfield time. So we were working as usual from morning 5 o'clock in Falodi, and we got around evening a call from Jodhpur, a nearby city in Rajasthan, that one of the aircraft is down. And we all know that in Gagan Shakti, we should ensure the grounding should not be happen on the aircraft, and the flight should be as usual as Air Force planned. So along with me and my technicians, we went to Jodhpur. So once we reached Jodhpur, it was night 11, and we took all the permissions and entered inside the base. Just note, this is a Gagan Shakti phase, so all bases of Air Force are in high alert as per Air Force protocols, whatever it is. So we have started our rectification on the aircraft with two technicians who are given a company, I mean, who has accompanied with me. So it was around midnight, 2 o'clock. Along with me, the squadron leader, who is also in charge of that night duty. So we had a small chit-chat, and after completion of the rectification on the aircraft, we went outside the hangar to see the other fighter aircrafts, where we saw some 10 to 15 Sukhoi aircrafts are parked. So the moment I went and just staring at those aircrafts, I could see a guard is coming opposite to us around 100 meters distance. It was casual. I thought it is a normal security man who will be guarding all these aircrafts. So he has almost approached 50 meters, and he is holding an AK-47 rifle, pointing on me and a squadron leader.
First time in your life?
First time in my life.
You're married?
I was married.
Your wife never pointed? All right, so AK-47 at you.
At me.
All right, at night? Yeah. Night?
Night, 2 o'clock.
2 o'clock? Yeah. Amazing, at an okay.
Hands up.
Hands up. So you are just hands up.
Yeah. He almost came near to 30 meters and he shouted hands up.
Yeah, so let us build the drama. 50 meters, yeah. 30 meters, yeah. All right.
So I don't know how to hands up also, because I'm a common man. I just raised my hands to waist level, that's it.
Okay.
Now, squadron leader, I was staring at squadron leader, what is happening here? Then he asked, tell me the code.
Code, okay.
Code. I thought some video game is happening here. What is this code and all? The squadron leader who is working with me, unfortunately, doesn't know the code, because I think that is the protocol they give who are all working midnights on the base. So he told, tell me the code. Squadron leader could not reply. Then he squadron leader told, I can show my ID card. And the guard told, you throw to near to me, not come. Right. Yeah. So, yeah, really, I don't know what is happening there. I don't know if suddenly he triggers, if he press the trigger.
All right. Nothing will happen. You will be dead. Yeah, because AK-47, even you wouldn't know.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's the advantage of it. Yeah, this is a great, great story for, you know, despite so much of challenges being threatened literally at an airbase, AK-47, we have Chakravarti luckily waking up the next day to share this story. Otherwise, you know, we would have definitely missed you, Chakri. Yeah. All right. So from a jovial note to the serious Gagan Shakti. So let me just go to, just hand over the mic. Gagan Shakti was one mission. Even Air Force officials tell us the kind of preparedness Team HAL had, the way Tejas performed, and, you know, the squadron pilots who also participated there, everyone, I think that was the ultimate test what Tejas successfully passed. Tell us about all those happenings there at the Gagan Shakti.
Hello, Anand. I am Prakash Singh. I am working in final assembly. When we were in Gagan Shakti, it was a full 24/7. We had to give coverage. We had to support IF. Our LCA was participating for the first time. It was real war-like situation was created. And we were in Faludi. So this war-like situation was full, I mean, for 48 hours. Where every time we have to be ready, 8 LCAs were positioned there. And every time, 2 aircrafts will be lined up, 2 will take off. Behind that, another 2 will be there with full armed. And believe us, the sound when the engines roared and took off to the skies with all the missiles, bombs and all, we were feeling very much thrilled as part of LCA. We have produced these aircrafts and that gave us a lot of proud. When the aircrafts landed, we used to ask the pilots, how was your experience, whether you were able to target the enemy aircrafts and all. They used to come and say, LCA is proving to be the best fighter aircraft now. Though it's indigenous, we were never, never thought that it will perform to such an extent. They used to come around 12 o'clock, 2 o'clock, and every time they used to land, LCA people will be there. And we will be there, we'll be asking the pilots, sir, any problem with the aircraft? They used to say no. If any problem, then and there only within 1 hour, we'll resolve the issues and we'll see the aircraft is serviceable. And so, I mean, the performance of LCA aircraft was stupendous.
All right, so Gagan Shakti was the real, real test of tests for Tejas, and it really proved the way it ought to. So let me now come to the front row, couple of very silent souls. Here, we have Deepa Das, right? So what is your area of responsibility in HAL?
I'm in project management, FOC program.
All right.
I'm from Kerala, and this I would like to say that this is my first job. Straight after college, I joined HAL fraternity, and it's my fourth year of association with LCA team.
Is that a special pride, a young girl from Kerala, first job?
Definitely. Like, I'm from a very conservative family. Coming here over to Bangalore all alone.
You came all alone. Nobody was in the bus or train.
So it was pretty difficult for me to gel into a work environment directly from college. I would say the emotional connect these people are having with the aircraft, the emotional connect they have straight from the senior management, from housekeeping staff, the enthusiasm they show when the aircraft goes for flight, and immediately they come and ask, madam, is it landed, like what is the issue, any issues, the emotional connect the entire team right from top down, what they're having with LCA is what makes it special compared to the other programs HAL has.
Is there any difference being the women force, the women power behind Tejas? Can we say like that? You have a lot of women behind?
Yes, sir. We have a lot of women behind. I think 30% here are women, including officer, the workmen, and the housekeeping. So including all.
So what is your area of responsibility?
I'm taking care of wiring part of LCA. So I would like to tell that wiring is one of the most complex. Complex in the sense because it is through and through, from nose to the tail, all the signal goes so through the wiring.
Alankrita, I remember a long time back, I think, I'm not sure who said it, somebody was telling that there are kilometers of wires inside Tejas. Is it true?
Yes, sir,
so
exactly.
How many kilometers?
Just it is 33 kilometers.
All right, 33 kilometers.
One thing I want to like to
add,
is our Indian.
He's in Assam. He's in shop. She's in inspection. Whatever he's assembling, she'll inspect.
All right. So, I want to know how this electrical connection happens.
So, 33 kilometers of wires.
Yes, sir. From nose to tail, all the signals goes through this wiring. It is like basically a function of communication. Communication from one connector, from one part to the other, from one LRU, one component to the other components. All is through this wiring. And it is one of the safest also, because we have, thanks to the design of LCA, it is having redundancy. So a lot of redundancy is there. So if one signal fails, other signals will take over.
Like, you are her husband. So, and you are from?
Bihar.
Bihar, Donam from UP. And you are from Bihar and she's from UP. So how did this, you are a mechanical engineer and she's an electrical. So you met here, maybe the first Tejas couple?
No.
Oh, acha. Idhar pura shaadi bhi ho jate hai project ke bare mein. All right.
So do you guys, husband and wife, do you go home and discuss wires and parts, or it's a strict no at home?
We always say we will not discuss, but through some way it comes on to LCA, and what is happening in LCA, that only will be ending up discussing.
All right, so LCA, so you have kids,
we have kids.
And have you named them as?
We thought of naming, but we thought at least let the kids be away from LCA. Okay.
What is the one thing you want to say about the FOC SP-21?
I think FOC SP-21 is one of the best fighter aircraft with all the advanced features. And we are actually very proud associated with this project. It's a robust wiring, and it will work in all weather, all condition. And I think for 50, 60 or 80 years, it will be like robust wiring with all advanced features.
Okay, nerves of the aircraft. Interesting. The robust wiring, the nerves of the aircraft. And she says that it will stay for 80 years. Tell me that, what is the future for HAL now with SP-21, or for the division? SP-21 has taken off, 22 is waiting in the wing, 23 and 24 also started to crawl. So it is going to be, and then it's a matter of time, you guys are already planning the trainers this year. By the time the 83 MK1 A orders will come, it is going to be a really, really busy division this. So what are your thoughts on that, Vasagam?
Thank you, Anath. You exactly brought out what is lingering in every one of the minds here. As you told, SP-21 landed is a very proud moment, and everybody sharing, including our ED, how we achieved this. A strong belief with our ED is, as you told, media is speaking, so much focus, in fact, too much of focus on media about this program. Sometimes you used to tell, why this much focus required for this program? Because allow us to work freely. But one thing he strongly believes, we need not comment anything about who speaks about that. Only our work will speak volume. The first and foremost thing what we achieved in the last 3 years, we have produced and shown this world we could deliver 8 aircraft last year, which never happened in the history of LCA. That gives so much of confidence. We could go and knock anybody's door. The highest platform of the program, let it be PGD. If you go to the Air Force, it is either CAS or VCAS or DCAS. Everybody started accepting the program because the Tejas division proved this can be produced and delivered for the first time. In IOC, we could do, we completed the 16 fighter. When it comes to FOC, provoking, we asked to get the advanced drawing. You will not believe on December 31st, when DG Aero handed over the document, still it has to be finalized on February 19 to ED. You will not believe, first our rear fuselage of FOC were tagged by CRI. That much proactiveness our ED has reviewed very, very meticulously. In a very lighter side, I will say, this Madurai meets Mysore in the morning, meticulous meeting with the aroma of the coffee. We'll start that actually. Our day starts with the aroma of coffee ED offers in the conference room. It's a very good start. When we started in 16, I remember still SP4 items were being loaded. Now we are tagging SP36 parts inside our stores. Because always there was a complaint, the supply chain is the very weak chain. Now it has become the most strong chain. Even others they are waiting for. When it comes to FOC program, we continuously had 65 weekly meetings, PGD camps down to our ED conference room with all the stakeholders, including Air Force, was addressing our problems. That is why now we could fly 21 today, and we were ready for 83. We were every meeting, they were asked how many aircraft we can produce per year. That is not the problem. Give us order. Because otherwise production gap will happen. That makes these people to give this clearance for this first 4 aircraft to accept by with the interim software also. because LCA Tejas Division proved this aircraft with air-to-air fuel, with the gun fitted, it is flown and come back. I strongly believe the people first division is LCA Tejas Division, and we will confidently will take with our 83 aircraft also.
I am Shriram Murthy, working in power plant and fuel systems.
I am sure looking at you, you are from either Air Force or Army.
I am from Air Force.
So what's your contribution to this?
I have been working here for past 12 years, and I am proud to be working with this wonderful machine. I came across a few aircrafts while working in Air Force. This is one of the best aircraft I have seen so far.
Okay, so you have seen LCA while in Air Force. Now?
No. After coming back, there was, by then that LSP-1 also not took off. After my joining only, the LSP-1 took off.
So after your joining, a lot of good things happened.
Yes.
Right, you're right. Okay, so let's straight away go to, everybody says you sing well. Maybe some 3-4 lines of a favorite song.
This song which I'm going to sing now, the spirit of this should inspire all of us in each walk of our life.
Oh, here is a song from an ex-Air Force warrior, now with HAL, and now he says that the spirit of this song should echo in this division, it should inspire everyone. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen.
Ruk jana nahi tu kahi haar ke kaanton se chal ke milenge saaye bahar ke ओ राही साथी न कारवां है ये तेरा इम्तिहान है यूं ही चला चल दिल के सहारे करती है मंजिल तुझको इशारे देख कहीं कोई रोक नहीं ले तुझको पुकार के ओ राही थैंक यू.
All right, so now let me just want to hear something, somebody who has worked with other projects and come. Is there anybody from other projects and come? Who all are there? You are there and then you are there. Okay, let me just come to you. You are directly on my target. So please tell me about from where, which project you were associated before and what's your take on the current status?
Thanks, Anant. I am Praveer. I am from Bihar. I am looking after fuselage structures assembly here in Tejas. So, last 14 years I have worked with Sukhoi.
Okay, so you came from Nasik.
I came from Nasik. So, last 2.5 years I am with Tejas division. So, more proudly I can say I am now a Tejas man from the ex-Sukhoi man. I can say that different situations. One situation is that in making a Sukhoi, a bigger monster aircraft, a state-of-art aircraft, and here, a lightest aircraft, a very compact aircraft, and Tejas, we can say that the challenge is that in TOT project, we have given everything and we can go as per the planning schedule and everything. But here, challenge is that you have got the design changes concurrently. When you are doing manufacturing, again, some changes are there. So you have to deal with that. And other thing is that space constraint. You have to accommodate everything in the small space. So that constraint is here. So this change is there.
So you are saying the challenges are more here.
Yeah.
Because you compact aircraft.
Yes.
Indigenous program, design changes. So that's interesting. So can I just talk to somebody? Somebody is from here, from quality, right? Who is that gentleman or lady? Sir, if you can identify yours and tell me about. Quality is something what people talk about a lot of Indian programs, not just at HAL alone. And there are concerns at times. There are, a lot of things said and written. And sometimes a lot of things are genuine. So tell me how critical, considering that touchwood by God's grace, right from 2001, Jan 4th till today. Flawless, so many variants. So Tejas quality has been definitely sky high. What are the things that contributed in it?
I'm Johnny Thomas from Kerala. I'm taking the responsibility of quality and customer services in LCA Tejas Division of HAL. Quality is the most important aspect in aircraft production and operation. It's a paradigm. Quality, reliability, risk management, safety. And it is something like a self-sustaining virtuous cycle.
So quality,
reliability, risk management, and safety.
Four factors, key factors.
Each one augment or reinforce the other. So it is something like a outwardly spiraling spiral.
What makes this mission the best in quality?
As we all know, LCA Tejas aircraft is perhaps the most complicated technological system. It is at the cutting edge of technology. And as Mr. Parveer already told, you know, it is very, not only it is a light combat aircraft, but it's a compact aircraft as well. There are space constraints and the avionics, and there are 344 line replaceable units or aggregates. Yeah, and you know, everything is put in this small bird. And you know, as far as maneuverability and other things are concerned, it's a pilot's pride. And I can tell, based on my experience of working with the LCA Tejas aircraft, this one particular product is the best product Indian engineers have produced. And it is at the cutting edge of technology.
So very interesting, pilot's pride. So you touched upon an aspect of pilots, because I understand, I am aware that a lot of pilots, right from Wing Commander Kotial to a lot of people flying now, a lot of people have contributed over the years for this mission. Their inputs have been very, very critical in designing, upgrading many systems. Can somebody talk about the pilot point, if I want to say? So, Prikshit, what is the pilot relationship this machine has got? Because it's a pilot's pride, that's what the pilots say. Can you talk about the contribution of pilots?
Anant, actually, looking at the ergonomics of this aircraft, this probably suits best the maximum anthropometric range of pilots which exist in India get fitted into this aircraft. So, by saying that, the handling qualities of this aircraft are good, and the man behind this machine is actually making it a most effective weapon system which is available in India today. If LCA as an aircraft performed very well in the exercises in which it has participated, yes, it's a good aircraft, but behind the aircraft, the crew, the air crew which has actually flown this aircraft was excellent. And the feedback which we have often got from most of the pilots is it's a flyer's delight. Means they need not tire themselves up flying this aircraft. It's an absolute pleasure to fly it. The pilot loads are reduced drastically because of the human-machine interfaces which are available in this aircraft are state-of-the-art.
The talking Tejas.
They call it the talking Tejas.
So basically it's a mission that has at times has got emotion. That is what the pilots say.
When we took this aircraft to Malaysia as well, you know, the most underrated thing about this aircraft was that everyone was seeing Tejas, you know, Tejas, the aircraft, the way it was performing. But the most underrated thing was the air crew was because they were quite unassuming in showing off what HAL or the Tejas was capable of doing. And in Malaysia, this aircraft has demonstrated to Royal Malaysian Air Force as well, wherein we could demonstrate the turnaround times which even some of the best contemporary aircraft could not show. It would not be appropriate to name them, but yes, it was an aircraft, and the testimony of this aircraft was given itself by our current chief. He was himself a test pilot.
Absolutely. I think, you know, the Chief of Air Staff, Air Chief Marshal Bhaduria, is a huge supporter of Tejas. Not just Tejas, a lot of indigenous programs. And in one of the interviews recently, he spoke at length about the different roles eventually Tejas will undertake in the years to come. So inspiring. He being a pilot, he has flown it, part of it. So that brings the question, if you can hand over the mic to the lady in the front. So you have been silently nodding, laughing, all that. Could you please identify and tell you about your contribution to this fantastic mission called Tejas?
Thank you, sir. I am Vadana. I am from Tamil Nadu.
Aruna.
Vadana.
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 Vadana, okay, all right. So you sing songs?
No, sir.
But you said Vadana and all that. It's like Sarigama.
Sir, actually, my wish to join HAL started when I was in college. When I came for an industrial tour here, at the time we visited HAL and NFTC. That provoked me to join HAL. So first attempt, I couldn't clear. Second attempt, I joined.
Oh, okay.
So I thought, HAL, there is some link.
So you decided I have to do a job, it has to be HAL.
I tried, sir.
Achha, you tried. Second attempt, you great. So where from Tamil Nadu you are from?
No, I studied in Tirupati, sir.
You studied in Tirupati, but you are from?
I am from. Native is Tirunelveli, Tamil Nadu.
All right, okay. So you were hell-bent on joining HAL.
I have been working here for past 14 years. I'm in the planning department. LCA is, something like change is constant in LCA.
All right.
We have produced 7 LSPs, IOC 16 numbers, and now we are in SP21. We have finished that one. Earlier, we were used to a lot of changes.
Changes from?
All the revisions, which were for the improvements.
Now, are you saying the changes have stopped or?
It is very minimal.
Minimal.
Huh.
But you are okay with changes?
We were okay.
But no more.
Now the changes are...
Okay. Yeah, because it has become a matured machine.
All the improvements, everything is done from the pilot point of view.
Has this machine any time or the project disappointed you?
Sometimes it happens, sir. But later it comes back to normal.
Fine, later it inspires you. The moment you see Tejas, it's like all your worries, So what is that you want to tell the young Vadanas and others across India? Here is a great opportunity.
Yes, sir. Lot of opportunities are there. People now mostly inclined towards software field. They have to definitely try towards this also. And there is a lot of environment which they have not seen at all is waiting for them.
So come and join Tejas division. Or HAL?
That too. Tejas is definitely unique, sir. Not like any other division.
What is your area of specialization?
My name is Suresh Shamsi. I am working basically in IT fitter. 2006, I got a job in HAL. Here, I'm proud to tell I am HAL. They given everything. My mother given me life. But HAL given to my mother life.
Very interesting thing, very, very touching thing when you talk about mothers and parents, let they live happily, healthy for a long time. A lot of people have different kind of image about HAL, all right? There is an HAL of the past, maybe there were issues, I'm not getting into it, but nobody talks about the current HAL. I'm being told this LCA division, there are many people who don't want to go on leave. There are many people who work on Sunday, Saturday. There are people who work till morning, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock. What is that drives you to come to office? What is that makes you to be part of this fantastic team? You please identify and...
I am Chandrasekhar.
Yeah.
I work in structure assembly and specialized in coupling fuselages. I am fortunate to be associated with Tejas. And if you are passionate, you can work 365 days and 24/7. There will be not problem. Actually, we are spending more time here than our home.
Is it okay at home? People are okay with you guys spending more time here?
Sometimes we make it some way.
There are issues. You don't want to talk to me. You can talk to me after this program.
Yeah, yeah. Sure.
One more thing. One more point is that we have here hunger to beat our best.
Hunger for more. Yes. 83 more is coming. More hungry. Mark 2 will come.
Like in the structures, we are working in structures, so whatever cycle time we have achieved, so we have to crash it and we have to make it.
All right, so...
No, sir, actually about home, as you say, how they react at home, you being office, but as much proud we feel being in LCA, that much proud our family also feel being us in LCA. They truly understand our contribution. So they are also like a part of LCA. They do say, okay, you be at office, we'll take care of family, don't worry.
Absolutely. So it's a large... So the Tejas family is growing and growing and growing. So can we just talk to the gentleman? I haven't gone to him, sir.
My name is BD Reddy.
All right, sir.
I am from the nearby state, Andhra Pradesh, Anantapur.
All right.
Prior to this, I worked in Air Force for 20 years. After that, I have joined this HAL. So when I joined HAL, that limited series production was going on. And I am closely involved with this project from the beginning, LSP1 onwards, up to this latest SP21. I have seen the first flight of LSP1 And I have seen this SP-21 first flight also.
I know that you are probably all the time inside a frying pan, but you still have a smile spotting on your face all the time. What is the secret behind this smile?
My secret is working with people.
Okay.
When I'm alone, I'll be depressed.
All right.
When I'm with the team, I'll enjoy.
All right.
I'll smile. So they were the supporters for me to come and continue the task or complete that task. They're well, know the objective, they're supporting me. That's why I always smile with my people. They're well motivated.
Okay, somebody told me, you know, I have got a lot of friends in HAL, so that during your daughter's wedding, apparently you, the boy's father, the entire family, you were the man who choreographed and all of you sang some songs in Kannada. Again, that could be a very rare thing in the, you know. But can we have just two lines of that in Kannada, maybe?
Maduveyai banda, anuragada hanubanda, yeledu janumadalu teerada sambandha.
All right, so these are all very, very rare visuals coming to you, that a happy-go-lucky LCA team and the team captain, you know, leading from the front. So as we are about to land, I wanted to ask two more things. Who was the person who worked on the refueling probe? Can somebody tell about, because this is the unit, isn't it, that... All right, so Prakash, if you can talk about the refueling probe, what one of the most key factors apart from the gun and other features, but how tough it was to integrate the probe?
We integrated probe on, this is first our FOC aircraft. We integrated the probe on this aircraft and we went for testing of this probe. The challenge was that we have to refuel the aircraft with 50 PSI, pressure refueling. So that 50 PSI we gave to the probe, and pressure refueling was carried out, and in just 5 minutes and 30 seconds, full internal aircraft was filled in just 5 minutes and 30 seconds. Full air, there was absolutely no issues, no fuel spillage, and the test was completely successful. So now with this, we can easily fill aircraft in air also, and refueling will be completed in just 5 minutes 30 seconds, full aircraft. In LCA, we don't come to do a job. We come here to fulfill our passion. It's the passion for us, it's not a job for us.
The passion, we come here to fulfill the passion.
Actually, I have worked in many divisions. In this division, I find one difference. Other divisions, we have to see GM, ED or some hierarchy. It will take 6 months or any big event is there, they will come. But in our division, that to our final hangar, morning 7 o'clock, we see our ED sir and COP sir. And evening night also, we see them. So their office shifted to final assembly. Okay, that is what is motivating us.
But are you happy seeing one man's face all the time or?
No. Earlier it was okay, but now we used to it.
Okay, earlier it was okay, now we are used to it.
No, they are now our colleagues. They are like our...
Achha, ghar mein toh kuch problem nahi hai na? Kuch bilkul nahi.
When sir was talking about quality, I recollected one lecture by one of my instructors while I was undergoing training in Air Force. What he said was in his first lecture, if a barber commits mistake, it will become a hairstyle. If a tailor commits mistake, it will become a fashion. And if a politician commits mistake, it will become a policy. But being an aviation person, if you commit mistake, it will lead to a disaster. So the standard of quality and precision required in aviation field is very, very, very high. So that is the precision with which we are working to produce this wonderful machine.
So in this occasion, one thing I want to tell, here, which we are all there, our team members. We are gone all the outstations. That means minus 25 degree and maximum is 50 degrees temperature, low altitude, high altitude, Rajasthan, almost all the, including Bahrain, Malaysia, all the places our team has been gone to support the our Air Force people. And we are successfully has come out. In this occasion, you are telling inspiration all... Passion, what I'm telling. Now also, our team is 24 hours, 365 days. We are ready to work with Air Force. If there are anywhere, anything is there, we are ready to go there and we'll do the serviceability and give the for the nation.
Yeah, so I want to just ask you, Mr. Yogi, I understand that LCA has got different names, right? You have apparently given a different name.
Yes, I'm proud to say that LCA means leadership styles of all individuals here. And their commitment, C, meaning achievement of aircraft.
So that is amazing. That is a very, very interesting thing. Leadership commitment and achievement. LCA also stands for that. That's it from our end. This edition of Tarmak Talking is ending here. What an inspiring story of Tejas. What an inspiring story of LCA Division. There are more people who have contributed. There are many more. Lot of unsung heroes are behind this fantastic mission. Everybody is passionate. Everybody wants to be part of Tejas program. Everybody wants to be part of Yogi's team. It is really, really inspiring. And let me just tell you, it is really, really a flat structure. There are no hierarchies. The doors are always open. You can walk in. That is a new HAL. The future of HAL may be scripted here with these kind of new age management thought process, out of box thinking. You heard it from them. We will bring more such stories to you from India's aerospace and defense sector. Thank you for watching us. Jai Hind. We'll be right back.